Welcome back, guys. Sweet Chris here. And this is going to be the first of a series of videos that I want to do where I basically bring you NetSuite news every month. So all of these different talking points of new releases, tools that have been upgraded, just events that are coming up, everything related to NetSuite, I want to kind of cull it all into one video every month that I can provide to you guys. So hopefully this is something that catches on and can become a really great resource for you guys to kind of have a one-stop shop of information about everything happening in NetSuite. And the way I'm going to organize it is I've got a number of different topics that I could cover, let's say a dozen topics, and based on what's happened in that given month, I'll pick maybe five or seven of them that are particularly interesting to talk about, and I'll condense those down into a video. So to get started, the first thing I want to talk about is the NetSuite release. And if you don't already know, the way that NetSuite upgrades their system is two times a year, they'll do an overnight update or a release for everybody that brings the entire system up to their new upgraded version. And there's a lot of different updates that are included in that. They do all kinds of really small cosmetic changes or quality of life, debugging little issues that have been coming up, but they try to put in at least a couple major upgrades or features so they have kind of something to talk about and show that NetSuite's making progress in the right direction. So the most recent NetSuite release occurred this past April. So I know it's not wildly new news, but there are some things that I think are still notable to talk about. And specifically, the big talking point for this release was the new AI tools. Now, if you went to SuiteWorld last year in October, and by the way, I'm going to talk about SuiteWorld more a little bit later, but if you went to that, you'll know that everything was about AI. And just in general in the world, the past year and a half has just been crazy on the subject of AI. So they talked about and really pitched a lot of things at the last SuiteWorld about how NetSuite's going to be having all these AI tools included in the system. And the new release that happened in April was really their first opportunity to roll out some of these AI products. So just a bit of background information on this. NetSuite partnered a little bit ago with a AI startup company called Cohere. And so Cohere is bringing the large language model to the table, and then NetSuite's bringing all these features to utilize that system and have these AI tools within NetSuite. So a few of them were brought out. Overall, I would say it wasn't anything mind-blowing, but it does show that they are going in the right direction. It'd be nice if they went a little bit faster, but they certainly have at least the right viewpoint. So a few of the things that did come out, and I will have a full video probably in the next month where I'm actually walking you through these tools and showing you how they work. But the first one is a text enhance feature where basically, let's say you've got an item record and you've got a text box description field for the item, you have an opportunity to put in just a few bullet points and you can click this little AI tool button and it generates a bunch of information on this description. So it'll take the keywords that you put in and it'll fill in a full description. So I've used this tool a little bit. It's definitely way too salesy and too kind of hyping up this product. I literally put in at one point the words gear motor and it wrote me a 300 word dissertation about how this was a cutting edge, top of the line gear motor. So it goes way over the top, but you know, this is an AI model. So as it gets more information and knows what's too much, what's not, it'll kind of rein in and hopefully be something that is a little bit more practical and can be used to save yourself the time on having to write out, in some cases, more lengthy descriptions. So that was one of the features. Again, one that was kind of cool to talk about, but not particularly helpful. They had another feature where, for example, if you're generating a new sales order with a customer, it will automatically suggest what should populate that sales order based on transactions that customer has previously, things that they've previously bought, et cetera. And again, that's kind of cool to talk about. It certainly can be more sophisticated. As of right now, it's pretty infrequent that a customer just identically buys the same things over and over again. So not wildly helpful, but can be, and with some slight modifications, it definitely can be a tool in the future that will be more helpful. And the one I think was the most helpful, not perfect, but going in the right direction for sure, is a bill scanning option where you can feed, let's say, a PDF of a bill that you've received from a vendor. It will scan that, recognize certain fields like due dates, agreement terms like net 30, the actual price itself, the date, these things. It will take them all off of this PDF and it will populate them into a bill in NetSuite. So that is definitely a helpful tool. In fact, I was talking to a client just today who wanted to utilize that tool. So it's something that can ease your quality of life when dealing with NetSuite. It's not perfect in terms of its ability to recognize fields and populate, kind of associate things in the right place, like if the wording is off. Again, I'll make a video where I walk through that and I talk about what it does well and not, but for now, understand it is something you should take advantage of if you've got a need for a lot of bills coming in that you need to just pull into NetSuite. And that, again, those were the highlights of that NetSuite release. So they're going in the right direction. They're certainly gonna have more features and improvements to these tools, but that was the major talking point. So the next topic I wanna cover is called the module spotlight, where I wanna focus on a particular tool or module in NetSuite, something that's native and sold by NetSuite, and talk about what the feature is like, its pros, its cons. I wanna call it spotlight just because it's not always gonna be a positive review. Some of these things definitely could be better, or there are third-party apps that do the function better. So in this particular video, however, it does relate to the news release or the NetSuite release because it came with that April release, and it is a product called, or I should say a module called, Field Service Management. And as the name implies, it is basically an app that can be utilized by companies that have some field service aspect. So maybe you do brake fixes or warranties and maintenance, anything where you've got, especially like service personnel that are going out into the field, then you would need some sort of an application to manage those field service personnel. Up until now, companies have had to rely on third-party apps exclusively, and one of the major players in that realm for NetSuite specifically has been a company called Nextechnic, which is an Australian company. They came out with a product called NextService that provided this amazing field service application. NetSuite bought Nextechnic last year. They've incorporated it into their own team and officially re-released it, really repackaged it, this last April with the big release. It is fully native NetSuite. It's not like a bolt-on integration. It's something that just happens within NetSuite. And you can check out the video that I did where I did a demo actually walking through FSM. But overall, if I had to describe it, I would say it is a really solid application. If you're a company that's already on NetSuite and has some element of your business that is field service, in many cases, it's gonna be a vital part of your business. In my opinion, it's a no-brainer to go with FSM. It's like with most things in NetSuite, it's not perfect. It's definitely not the most intuitive system to use, but it's solid. It's native NetSuite. It works pretty well. It's not that hard to get your grip around and get familiar with, and it does the job really well. So if that's a part of your business, then it's definitely something that you should check out. Again, I have a video specifically walking through FSM if you want to see if that's something you can utilize. All right, so the next thing I want to do is just a quick highlight on one of the super training courses. I've got 8 courses at this moment in time, and I've got a few more on the near horizon. So we're constantly building up that curriculum, but one in particular I want to highlight, if I had to say the course I'm most proud of, would be the Administrator Fundamentals course. It's one that, although it's not necessarily the cheapest course that's available, in my opinion, it definitely has the most bang for its buck. If you're someone that's either an existing administrator and you want to expand out your tool set, or you're looking to expand onto NetSuite as an administrator or a consultant, I get emails from people that are looking to make that career change all the time. It's the course that really just handles literally all of the fundamentals, roles and permissions, save searches, the IT function of it, workflows, customizations. It literally has everything in that one course. So, and certainly if you want to get your Suite Foundation and your admin certification, doing that course literally puts you leagues ahead of being able to pass that exam. So if you want to take advantage of just one course that can cover so many bases and put you a step forward in pursuing a NetSuite career, then that is the one that I have to bring up and have to recommend as a very useful. It's almost 60 videos and there's really just so much you can get out of it. I get great feedback all the time from that course. So the next topic is going to be an upcoming events section. And if you know NetSuite, they do events all throughout the year, all across the country, at least in the United States, where they'll have seminars and lunch and learns and growth seminars, all these different things to try to make things more accessible for the client base. They've got one in St. Louis and I think another one in Nashville coming up in just a couple weeks. So always events on the horizon, but really the major event of the year is always SuiteWorld. SuiteWorld is their big convention. They have once a year, 10,000 people arrive. It's a huge deal. And because that's coming up soon, it's one that I want to talk about in this video. And of course, I'm going to talk about it in the next month's update. And if you haven't been to SuiteWorld, it's really like any other convention, right? They take a huge hotel, they book it out. There's a giant expo hall. They also have all these breakout rooms where they have seminars. There's tons of people, there's clients, there's vendors, there's tons of NetSuite people. It's definitely a pretty happening scene for the NetSuite world. And I totally understand it from a standpoint of the vendors and the partners. When I talk to clients, because a lot of clients go, and sometimes I'm a little surprised because it's not certainly not a cheap event to go to. The price as of right now is about $1,900. And then on July 27th, it goes up to $2,200. And you can get discounts if you're going in a group or let's say you work for an NGO or something like that, but it's not cheap. You got to pay for hotel, you got to pay for flights out to Las Vegas, and it's literally one of the hottest times of year in September 9th till the 12th. So I don't know why they choose that time for Las Vegas, but it, again, you've got flights, hotels, all these different things. You got the tickets themselves, not to mention you're off work for a week. So it's definitely a large investment to go even for a single person. And when I talk to clients, there's really two reasons that they decide to go. The first reason is they have either some major problem that they're trying to solve, maybe something's not working, or they're trying to find a solution to some issue. Or they're just simply not fully happy with their NetSuite system, or they're looking to kind of expand things out and they want to look at the wide range of other vendors and apps and kind of see what other modules and tools in NetSuite that they can take advantage of. And that I understand. There's definitely just such a display. They have these rows of various apps that people are giving demos for. There's definitely a benefit of that. Certainly if you have a specific problem, I do think there are more cost-effective ways to try to resolve that. And I'm hoping that with this specific series, these NetSuite news videos, that I can provide a lot of information and a lot of neutral, kind of independent information to give you a concept of what products to choose, what to avoid, how to kind of get around certain pitfalls so you don't necessarily have to spend a lot of money out of pocket and be off work to go to something like SuiteWorld. But again, if you're interested in that, I would recommend it as just an event and something that you really can get a lot of ambiance and environment for that NetSuite ecosystem. It's a big deal. So the next segment is going to be an app of the month. So every month, I'm going to pick one particular app that I think is notable or does a great job in that particular area and talk about that. It won't be a full demo, but I'll just kind of have some talking points and highlights regarding that app. And the first one I want to do for this particular video is one that I've actually reviewed. I haven't reviewed this particular product, but I've reviewed other ones from this company in recent videos, and I'll put a link up for some of them up here. But it is a product by NetGain called NetClose. And first, just to talk about NetGain, they are a not brand new company. They've been around for a little while, but it's basically this team of very young, gung-ho, enthusiastic accountants. And they make all of these different products that are accounting related. So things for fixed asset management and bank reconciliations and leasing and all these different things that NetSuite does, but it's a bit rigid and it's not always the most user-friendly. And these things, especially if you've ever had to use fixed asset management, you know what I'm talking about. They come out with these products that provide all the flexibility that you need, a lot of different options, and really quality of life improvements for these areas that for some companies are a major headache in as part of what they're doing in NetSuite. So specifically NetClose, again, anyone who's had to do a month-end close in NetSuite knows that the checklist that you do in NetSuite is not your month-end close checklist. You have to have a separate checklist because there's all kinds of things you have to do that are not included in the NetSuite one. You can't customize it at all. There's certain things on there that are gonna be completely irrelevant for your company that you have to do anyways, or you at least have to kind of sign them off. it's just not a perfect functioning system. It's kind of rigid in what it has you do, and it kind of just forces you down a certain path, and you have to do all of these other things in addition to it to do a proper month-end close. So net close, basically, and it's fully native in NetSuite, so it's not providing some other website you have to go to, but it basically allows you to do all of your actual month-end close functions within NetSuite in a way that's just simple. I'll do a full demo on it, I'm sure, at some point, but these things that are just so frustrating about a month-end close, they make it flexible, easy to use, and simple so that you can take what is otherwise a pretty painstaking process to something that's pretty routine and easy to slide through. So if that's something that's interesting to you, by all means, check out the NetClose product. I'm not sponsored by them, I swear to God. Their quality of service, customer service, their implementations, they really tend to go over the top to service their clients. So by all means, check them out. They're worth your time. And the last thing I want to talk about is career options. So I know a lot of you guys, at least in terms of the emails that I get and the comments on YouTube, a lot of you guys are trying to make a new career in NetSuite, or you want to kind of branch out in your career regarding NetSuite. So I want to give you some tips and have a segment every month where I just kind of give you some information or opportunities that can help you in your career. The first kind of point on that I want to talk about is I am developing like a full website in addition to my course website, where I'm hoping and I'm planning to have like a job board on there where companies can post administrator positions that they need and consultants that they need. And then people like you can come to the website and take advantage of some of these opportunities and apply for jobs that are available there. So that's a service hopefully I'm coming out with in the next few months. But just in terms of career opportunities with NetSuite, what I want to say in this video is just that if you're on the fence, and a lot of people that comment to me are kind of indecisive, or they want to jump in, but they don't know if it's the right time. Up until now, if you don't already know this, up until now, the people that are existing NetSuite administrators or consultants, there's really only a few paths that they were able to get there. Either they were like a college student and they went through the NetSuite route and they got trained by Oracle NetSuite and then kind of pushed out as a consultant, or they were in a company that had an existing software they had to implement and transition over to NetSuite. And in the process of doing so, they learned just by hook and by crook, they learned how to figure and how to work the system. And then they sometimes go on to be full-fledged administrators or consultants, et cetera. But it's always been a tough process. There hasn't been a streamlined path to get in as a new NetSuite admin or even developer. That's been up until now. If you think about it, the two things you really need to do or need as a resource to become a new NetSuite admin, you need some sort of a demo account or environment so you can actually utilize and work with the tool, and you need some kind of training materials and courses. Now, I can't provide you a demo account. I know people ask me all the time. Unfortunately, that's not a problem that I have solved yet in terms of actually having demo accounts that people can utilize. However, the training materials up until now, it's only been with NetSuite themselves. The official courses were LCS, and those ones, if anyone's ever done an LCS course, you know, enough said, but that was literally the only option. And if you weren't with a company that already had an LCS license, you didn't even have access to that. So you had to learn without access to an actual NetSuite account and without access to course materials, it was almost impossible to break into that industry. So as of right now, the NetSuite ecosystem is growing. There's more and more customers switching to NetSuite every year. It's definitely, it's been growing the last few years, and it's gonna continue to grow at least for the next few years. We'll see about the long term, but it's a great environment for job opportunities. And now, hopefully with SuperTraining, and even if you don't want to pay for the courses, there's a lot of content on this channel that if you simply watch all the videos that are here for free, you will know more than what most existing NetSuite administrators know. So now is the time to take advantage of this. If you've been looking for a career change, NetSuite is a fruitful place for that. And the materials at least are available. Again, at one point, I hope to solve the problem of how to get access to a demo account. Please don't ask me about it right now. I don't have them as of yet. I will let you know as soon as I have a solution to that. But overall, I do suggest you take advantage of the NetSuite world and the expansion that's occurring there. And that really wraps up this inaugural NetSuite news video. I hope you found this helpful. If you did, please hit that like button. Subscribe if you want to see future videos like this. And let me know down in the comments what sections maybe you found helpful in this video and what sections or topics would you like to cover in next month's video. So with that, I'll see you next time.